guys, we're off on his little jaunt, looking for a bit of a wild camping spot, and see how we get on. I've just been inquiring about these tents. I could have bought a bivvy bag, but saying that, buying a bivvy bag, oh the bloody hell, there's a bloody boat sunk here. I'll show you in a sec. Oh dear, somebody's got problems, a boat sunk. I could have bought a bivvy bag, but same price as a good bivvy bag you can get a tent for. So I'm looking now at the what do they call it, Vango Sabre 200. Now whether it'd be any good for me or not, it's only at length, like Mark said about this, come on Doug, Mark said about this Coleman Cobra 2, but there's not enough room for your feet height wise, but it's plenty of room otherwise, like. But so we're on this little jaunt. I've got Dougie with me, this boat that's sunk here, look, oh dear, it's Titanic time, oh dear. That's not going to be going very far. Houston, we have a problem. Oh dear. There's one further up, more up there. Got my other little pal with me today, look. Old Dougie. See what he's like. I haven't let him off lead yet, but I'm going to... There's a woman up there with a dog, but I'm going to let him off in a bit. Oh dear, it's Titanic. So, I've been looking at tents. Obviously I'm 6'4", 22 stone, so I'm not a small chap, so we have to see what I can get. I don't want to spend hundreds of pounds and up daft like that. Maximum's going to be like 100 quid. That Cobra, Mark had a Cobra Coleman, he said it weren't plenty wide enough or long enough, but once you lay with your sleep mat, your feet's touching top of the tent, which is no good. I know Dean Sturrock's got a, I think it's a, what is it now, Sabre 300, but to walk about with it's a little bit large like, so 200 I thought might be all right. Now he said I'd get in it, but only just, so we'll have to see. Anyhow, it's only just for other nights. Anyhow, this way Dougie, come on, this way lad, Doug, come on. So, he's quite happy. I'm going to have a walk on here. It's about 5 mile roughly. Bit of fresh air, nice day, can't fault it. This dog goes out every time, comes back and pees and craps on garden, so I'm trying to take him out for a bloody good day out and see if he'll have a pee on his way. Hopefully well, I'll give him a good praise if he does, like, but that's always been used to going out back garden. See, he hasn't been took out for walks, that's why. He's used to peeing on garden. Daughter said that he does that, goes out and then comes back on guard and kills 18, you scruffy twat. Right guys, I'm going. I'll catch you in a bit. Well, we've let him off at first time, he's alright, he's not bad. Still not had a pee yet. This is a view from this bottom track. And that's Jaffa distance over there. And Bazza further across, between them two trees right across. Fair old trip out today, lovely. Come on Douglas, Sunday name that Douglas. Dougie, come on. Doug. Bloody animals. Here we've got me pack on, me, what do you call it, Gordon 30 litre from Alp Kit. Comfortable as hell it is, but I wouldn't like to pack it out fully, have a lot of weight in it, like. It's just obviously there's no padding on shoulder straps, so, but it's comfortable enough for a little day hike and that, little walk and that, spot on, great. Right, I'm waffling guys, I'll fetch you back in a bit. It's like Dumbo running about with them big ears. Come on, have a pee, lad. Duck's getting up there. No 12 bore. Bit windy, breezy. This is what really does does my head in, this. Really does my head in. Why the hell pick it up to put a bloody bag on path? God, look at that. Why do that? It does me in. Just leave it if you're not going to bloody pick it up. Kick it into edge. Jesus Christ. Dirty bastard people. Excuse my French. Catch you in a bit. This is one spot I've found, guys. Here, look. I know it's a bit of a pathish, but it wouldn't be bad camping there, would it? Side at river. Not a bad little spot. There's a rabbit run or air run straight through it, like, but I'm not bothered about that. I know somebody must have been fishing here at some point, because it looks like a little fishing spot to me. But see, you're off track. Track's other side. That's a wooden grass track on top. And then main track for cyclists and walkers is further across. Interesting. That could be a one spot. Come on, Douglas. That could be a decent spot, that. It's off the beaten track. And it's all down there as well. Like, you're out at way, but I think that's more out at way down there. I don't know. See. I'll have a look. Alright, guys, catch you in a bit. See what I mean, guys? This track's here, look. That riverbank's other side of them woods here. So nobody's gonna see you up there, no way. So anyhow, we'll have a look later on. Might come back that way if we can get. So I'll catch you in a bit. I don't like the look of that. Just sat down to have a brew. And Dougie's just decided to do a runner. So I've had to go and chase him for about a quarter of a mile. So he's had a crack. No, he hasn't. Have you? You don't run off though, Dougie, do you? Eh? Good lad. What a beautiful spot here. This is off the beaten track, look. Some good places for a camp actually up here. There's a house there, like, so you couldn't camp too close, but that's the other side of the river. Nice spot. I'm just contemplating whether to get kettle out or wait for this go over. I've got my poncho, so I can unhook it all and make it into a bit of a tarp for us, like, so. We will see, give it 5 minutes, sat here, and see what happens. Pain. Catch you in a bit. It's looking like poncho time. Looked at weather forecast for a come out. No rain for us today, not a spot of rain. It's absolutely hammering it down over there. Absolutely hammering it down. It's like a storm job to me, I don't know. So I want to get my poncho out and get under this for a bit until it passes. Blue sky at back of it. If we can get in between that bit and that bit, if it blows though, we might just miss it, but I can't see it myself. It's coming across. So right, guys, I'm going to hunker down and get wet through. See you in a bit. Bit of beef spewing dumplings. Took his mouth watering, look. These stewing dumplings. Supposed to be. Wrap pack. And a nice coffee. GSI. I'll get back in a bit. Alright, guys, that's as had as dinner. Had a brew. All packed up. Leave no trace. Took all those rubbish ways. Also picked another sweet wrapper up from back of here. That can go home. Oh, Douglas, I think he's enjoyed it. It doesn't look like he has, like, but when that rain didn't get us anyhow, we had a quick few spots and that were all we had. But it's I'm on a bit grey now, so I'm going to head back about, I don't know, maybe a mile and three quarters, 2 miles to go, something like that. Before this next lot comes up, looks like it's going to rain again, look. So much for weather forecast, bloody rubbish weather forecast, they just get paid for out. I'm sure what they do, you know, they get up in the bedroom window in the morning, look out, open curtains, they think, we'll tell them it's going to rain, looks a bit dull today. Get about £1,000 a week for that, it's not bad, is it? I'd do it for 500 quid a week. I've enjoyed it. Nice little walk, legs are a bit stiff, like I'm not used to it. But I have to get used to it. So I've enjoyed it, it's been alright. I'm hoping to go for a walk when we go to Edale, to pub and back. So I shall have a little walk somewhere. I've got a map and everything, so I'll just have a little walk somewhere. Take him for a walk, Dougie. I can see him being a total pain. So anyhow, never mind. Right guys, I will fetch you back in a bit when we're on his way. I'm just going to have a quick vape on this for 5 minutes and then we're off back. Spot on, nice time out. Oh, another thing I was going to say. I still don't know what to do. I don't know, to get another tent for wild camping or just to take a tarp and buy a bivvy bag. I don't know what to do. Don't know. Tarp and bivvy bag or tent. Let me know. Under this lot, comment. Tarp and bivvy or tent. What would you do if you were in my shoes? My size. 13s. 22 stone. 6'4". What would you do? John? This is where it's at. Right guys, my thoughts on this Alkip Gordon 30 litre bag. It's spot on. It's alright for a day pack. Or maybe overnight if you don't take a lot of kit. But it's not comfortable as packs if you weight it out. You know what I mean? There's no padding on shoulder straps. But that's broke on mine already, look. Must be a... what they call it on it. Ever so thin that bit is, it's thinner than what that one is. So obviously it won't make any difference, not make the fault of bag like at all, but it's spot on, it's alright for that price, 28 quid waterproof. Can't fault it for a day pack, it's brilliant. I should use it all the time for a day pack. So like it. But I couldn't load it out maximum to ilk. Because me having big shoulders and that, it's gonna dig in eventually. But I like it, it's alright. It's a light idea with big long pockets on the outside and all. So, but it is, it's alright. Spot on. Right guys, catch you in a bit. To be honest guys, this pack, it rides better without chest strap closed. For the simple reason, it's not meant for a person like me, a big person like me, to be honest. It's meant for a thinner, not as broad-shouldered or wide chest or whatever. But saying that, look, it's fine. It's just a little bit short here, as you can see. But it's fine, as long as you don't load it out, it's spot on. For my size, if I loaded it out, I would imagine it'd get a bit uncomfortable, like, but... but it's as it is now, you can't tell you've got it on its back, on your back, like, spot on. It's nice, it's alright. For 28 quid, it's spot on. Can you fault it? Yep, we've about another, I don't know, half a mile to go now. And then we're back to car. I've enjoyed it. Dougie's enjoyed it. Been a nice time out, apart from him buggering off once, like, but it ain't that bad. You can see all the way through there, look. All fields and everything, lovely place. Lovely part of the country to live, Lincolnshire. It's a beautiful place, I love it. That lot across there, oh dear. Hopefully that'll come by the time I get back. I've got a bit of blue sky coming this way. Been lucky, really. It's basically passed me apart from odd quick little tiny little spray, lighting out the coal out. Look at that there, it's absolutely hammering it down over there, look. Like I said before, bloody weather forecast, man, rubbish. Absolute garbage. No rain for Lincolnshire, yeah, right. It's been alright. Nice, nice little steady stroll with him. It's not, I think it's maybe about 4 miles, that's all. Four and a half tops. But it's nice. Nice to be able to get out. I can't wait for Edale, I'm looking forward to Edale this time. I shall be going on Thursday, I can't go Wednesday because Mrs. Gusta Bingo Wednesday, so I don't rock the boat. Somebody coming with me though, I'll catch you in a bit. There's all this bottom bit and all, look, that's where the path is, the top of that mound. And there's all this bottom bit, but I don't know, there's a farmer's gates here. I don't know whether they do come down here or whatever, but there's no tyre tracks out on there. But, I wouldn't like to drink that, it's full of bleeding crap, that is. But, just for another night, I don't know. I think I prefer the first place where I said, off that track and down at side of the river, where somebody must fish down there, like, but they're not going to fish at night, I wouldn't have thought, like, but. Anyhow, you never know. I shall give it a whirl anyhow, whether I buy a tent or whether I buy a bivvy bag, I don't know. It's got to be a big bivvy bag for me. I'll be looking at them, I think they call them Hunker, I think they call them, from, go on Doug, Hunker from, what do they call, Alkit, XL. Go on Dougie, bloody mouse always sniffing at. They're 50 quid. So I thought for another 20 quid you could have bought a tent, like, you know what I mean? But I don't know. You have to let me know, guys, what you would do. We'll see what happens. But this is that other bit, like I showed you earlier on. There is a track up to it, but I don't know if people walk on it. But they're saying that I won't come that afternoon anyhow. It'd be an afternoon anyhow, like. But I think once you're out at way, more some cyclists and dog walkers anyhow. And I think once you're out at way and down there, look, I think you'd be already a track healer. So somebody must come fishing to it. If you get set up down there. What a lovely view in the morning to wake up to the river. Probably will go there, I would think. There's a farm gate there, old tyre tracks down there, but that's not recent, nothing. So we'll have to see. Anyhow. Right guys, that'll be it for this one. I hope you've enjoyed my little look for a place to camp. Bit of wild camping. If you can call it wild camping up here, like, but it's not very wild, is it? I know I've got Bazza and Jaffa and all that lot, and all these woods here. That wood that you see in front of you, that's pool wood. That's, I think it's birch wood, that. That's Jaffa, right across there. And all the woodland you can see at back of them trees there, I've got permission in all that lot. That one there. And that one there, but it's just fancy somewhat different, that's all. Just a nice change in the tent, side at river. It'd be nice, why not, you know what I mean? I don't drink so much now and I don't smoke, so I like to buy a bit of new kit and do different things, which I enjoy doing. You're only here once, guys. You're only here once. Nobody's ever come back and said that they've been second time round, have they? So I think this is it, you're only here once. See, there's this bit down there, look, because you're off track here, that's track down there. But you still get some dog walkers on this top bit, so it was bust his car tyre tracks here, look, you can see them. Well, 4x4 tracks. Unless that bloke who comes and cuts it, I don't know. Not sure. But anyhow, I'm waffling again, look. Won't take me long to waffle, does it? I'm just, hope you've enjoyed it. Coming with me for a look about. Take Dougie for a walk, a bit of dinner, brew. Sit down. I've enjoyed it, it's been nice, bit of fresh air. Spot on. Right guys, that's it for this one. Unless there's no interesting to show you, I'll see you on the next one. I've got some stuff coming. Massive box full for one tigress. I should be doing each individual looks at them. And then reviews later on. I'm taking all the stuff to Edale. The full box. I'll be taking all my through night torches to Edale. Steve at Through Night contacted me saying they've got a brand new head torch out. It don't come out while May. As soon as he gets one in, he's going to send me one on. And it takes AA batteries instead of 18650s. A lot lighter. Probably plastic, I don't know if it is or not light. So that's, I think it's the T, is it TN20? Or TH20, I'm not quite sure. He's going to send me that out, so that should be good. I think that's the main thing that we use, lacking it really, head torches and that. And we'll see what that's like. I'm at it again, I'm bloody waffling again, look. Right, I'm going. Catch you later on, guys. Thanks for watching, bye for now. Oh dear. Got a problem. I think it's taking water in. Just a little bit. Can I whistle up here now? Right, here we go again, waffle time. See you later.
Don't forget, let's be careful out there.